I watched Strange Magic. This is an animated movie produced and written by George Lucas. The story is about these two kingdoms, the Fairy Kingdom and the Dark Forest. The opening of this movie sounds like it was written by a five-year-old, though I think a five-year-old could probably do better. We open up with our main character, who is a fairy named Marianne, and she's about to get married, but she stumbles upon her fiancé, Roland, with another woman. And because of that, she instantly becomes emo. And after a time skip, I don't know how long, I guess a couple years, her sister Dawn is boy crazy and Marianne wants to protect her from boys. But an elf named Sunny is helping Dawn to get boys because Sunny actually really likes Dawn, but will do anything to make her happy, even though she will be with another person. And Roland, who is the fiancé of Marianne, still wants to become king, so he still tries to go after Marianne. And by the way, he sounds like a very cheap Matthew McConaughey. Also, the current king, who is Marianne and Dawn's father, looks like George Lucas. Sunny is disappointed about the fact that Dawn doesn't really notice him, so Roland takes advantage of that to tell him to get a love potion from the Dark Forest, since the Dark Forest is where the Sugar Plum Fairy is being held by the Bog King, or the Bug King. It wasn't really clear whether it's Bug or Bog. And that all escalates very quickly. Though it didn't feel quick! I was checking my phone, like, every 5 minutes to see if the movie was over yet. Because, first of all, the movie is very ugly. Remember how I told you about the beginning scene of Maleficent? And how everything just looks bad? Imagine that for an hour and a half. I mean, the animation is pretty good, it just looks bad. And the faces of some of the characters just have that uncanny valley feel to it. Thankfully, two of the main characters are decent to look at, the Bog King and Marianne. And by the way, the Bog King actually hates love. So he destroys all the flowers that grow along the edge of the Fairy Kingdom and the Dark Forest, because those are used to make the love potion, so he just destroys all of them. Just as soon as they sprout, the goblins come up and just destroys them. This is sounding a lot more complicated than it should be. Overall, the movie isn't really that bad. It's just kind of mediocre, is what I would say, if it wasn't for one other thing about the movie. And that's the fact that there are so many pop song covers. Seriously, it's almost every 5 minutes. I'm talking recent, old, in between. Even some of the instrumentals are pop song covers! There's this one scene where they're getting chased by a lizard, and the instrumental that's playing is a cover of Barracuda by Heart! Why did you need to do that? I don't think there's any original music in this movie whatsoever. And every time they start singing, I was like, oh god, why? This is the same reason I didn't like Book of Life as much as everybody else did. Though, the difference is, Book of Life was actually pretty good. This was just... eh. And a lot of the jokes don't really work that well either. I didn't laugh at anything in this movie. I laughed more at some of the previews than I did during the actual movie. Anyway, like I said, it's not that bad. The worst movie I've reviewed on this channel is still Walking with Dinosaurs 3D. That was terrible. This is still better than that. But to be honest, it really isn't worth your time. So those are my thoughts. If you saw the movie, hopefully you didn't, then tell me down in the comments, and I'll see you next time. Bye. I just wanted to say thank you to all my patrons this month. Your support really helps me out, so thank you, thank you, thank you. And if you want to become a patron, just click that annotation right there. Or if you want to see more movie reviews, click the playlist. And if you're not subscribed yet, hit the subscribe button. See you in the next video!